Guys, today's video is a concept form development diagram in Illustrator, so let's get started. The first thing that you are going to need is a SketchUp model of your design. Like, I built this, like, who am I? The next thing we're gonna do is go into Window and open the styles and choose this style. From that SketchUp model, you can then start creating different other diagrams, kind of explaining how you got to that design, and it's always best to start with the most simplest representation. Afterwards, I'm going to go into camera and go into parallel projection, and then I'm going to press on this one, which means zoom extend, and then I'm going to click on this one, which is the isometric view. And if you don't have that, all you have to do is right click on this toolbar here and then click on views, and that will open that right up for you. We're going to save that scene just in case we need to export it again, and then go into file, export, 2D graphic, and then export that into PDF. This is how the file should look like in the end, and then we can start working on Illustrator. If you guys have been watching my channel for a while, you would know that I am not very familiar with Illustrator, but since it's summer, I've taken this opportunity to learn Illustrator on Skillshare. It's honestly the best platform to learn different softwares, to learn any new skill, hence the name. They have so many different courses on design, business, and more. The course that I've been using to learn Illustrator is this course by Daniel Scott, who is an Adobe certified instructor. And as you can see, I've only watched just a few lessons, but I do feel comfortable to start creating on Illustrator. And the best part is Skillshare is so affordable because it is only under $10 a month. And you can watch this class and all of the other classes on Skillshare. And if you click the link in the description box, you can get 2 month free premium membership. So I would highly suggest you watch this class and the rest of Skillshare. So now let's get back into Illustrator. The first thing that you need to do is open the PDF on Illustrator, and then let's make sure that we both have the same workspace. So if you go to the top here, click on Essentials, because that means that we're both on the same. Where you are using an older version of Illustrator, I would suggest updating your Illustrator to 2019 so that we can all work in the same workspace. So now using the artboard tool, I can then crop this board to make it a bit smaller. You don't really have to do this step, it just makes it a bit more manageable for the time being. So as you can see, the lines have exported from SketchUp as dashed lines for some reason. So all I'm gonna do is select the whole thing. And if you go into stroke, you can see there's a check here that says dashed line. So all you have to do is uncheck it. Wow, that's really easy. Who knew that Illustrator is this easy? So now I'm just going to group each of these diagrams separately so then I can space them out if I need to, but I've already done so in SketchUp. The lines that have exported from SketchUp are just lines. Illustrator doesn't recognize them as surfaces and shapes. So to fix that, what you're gonna do is use the Shape Builder tool. If you click once and then drag, it will combine all of these lines into one shape. And if you click once on one surface area, as you can see, it will transform it into shape. So you're gonna do that for all of the faces that you need colored in your diagram. So I've added a screenshot of this diagram draft that I did in Photoshop just to get the colors right. But if you're struggling to come up with colors for your diagrams, I'd highly suggest watching the video that I've made about how to create your own color palettes. So all I'm gonna do is click the surface and then, using the eyedropper tool, color it. It's really that easy. So now, because of this base, it's not recognizing that it's a shape, and I think it's because it was exported from Digimap to SketchUp, so it's made from tiny, tiny lines. So what I'm gonna do is select the whole thing, join it together, and then use the Shape Builder tool to turn that into a shape. I'm going to select the whole thing and change that stroke into something really light and simple, so maybe 0.5, and then change that color into black. My default workspace only added the basic tools, which are on the left side, but Illustrator has a lot more tools. So to get the advanced tools, click on these three buttons here and then go to the top and press on this to get the advanced tools. So as you can see, now we have a lot more tools to play with, and I'm going to select the line. Yes, it's the simplest tool, but it's also very effective to create arrows. So what I'm gonna do is just draw a line and change that stroke into black. And then if I go down to stroke, I can then change the head and the bottom of the line to be an arrow. And all I have to do is select it. That's so crazy. I'm selecting number 12, which is a simple arrow that I like. And then I'm going to add that to the top and bottom and then change the weight of the stroke to be something thicker so that it has a bit more hierarchy. So now to add hierarchy into the building, I'm going to select all of the faces and copy and paste it. And then I'm going to go into Pathfinder and press on this, which will unite all of the shapes into one shape. And then you can add a thicker line weight, which gives hierarchy to your building. Using the white arrow, I'm going to select on each of these anchor points and then just delete them. So then afterwards, I can select this whole thing and join it together so that it's one line. And then I'm going to remove the fill so then we can add that over the big diagram. And if you want to move it and be really precise, all you have to do is click on this anchor point or any other anchor point and move it onto the correspondent anchor point and it will just snap in place. I'm gonna do the exact same thing using the shape builder tool. I'm just going to click once on all of these surfaces to turn them into shapes. And then I'm just going to click once to select them and then using the eyedropper tool, which is the shortcut I, and then you can just select and color in all of the other surfaces. I had some duplicate lines in SketchUp, so they also exported onto Illustrator, so all you have to do is just click the black arrow or the white arrow and just get rid of them. Also going to add a rotate arrow because I want to describe how the tower that's on the left has been shifted to create this dynamic relationship between the other tower and the vertical courtyard. To do that, we're going to use the circle tool and create an oval. And then using this right here, this will add an anchor point. So what I'm gonna do is click once on the area that I want to make a gap. It will make sense when you see the whole thing at the end. So I'm just going to add an anchor point here, for example. And then if we go into properties and click on this here, this will disconnect the anchor points. So then you can delete the lines between them. So you can delete this line or I'm gonna delete this line. Afterwards, what you can do is just add an arrowhead. It's as easy as that. Now try to do that in Photoshop. It will drive you insane. So this is one way to do the rotate arrow, but you can also just download tons of icons online from websites like Flat Icon. If you sign up, it's totally free. From there, you can then just download different icons on literally everything and then just add them to your diagram. So I'm gonna add this kind of curvy arrow to represent the wind because I'm trying to explain the environmental aspect of the design and the courtyard. Scale these icons up and down and then change these colors to fit with your diagram. I'm going to do the exact same thing now, copy and paste the whole thing. And using the Pathfinder, I can then unite the whole thing into one shape, add a thicker stroke and a no fill. You can also arrange things on Illustrator, so I want these arrows to be in front of the building, so you can just right click and then move them forward. So now for this diagram, we're going to do the exact same thing, but this time is only for the roof. I'm just going to do that with the shape builder tool as before, add the purple color, and I've also added a green color to all of the green spaces on the rooftop garden. So now let's start with the final diagram. We're going to do the exact same thing. But this time I'm going to have to use the shape builder tool on a lot of surfaces to create them as shapes to show the landscape. To add the stroke to the building, it's quite difficult to do it as before because Illustrator doesn't recognize these as shapes, so we won't be able to do the exact same thing as we did before. But what we can do is just use the line tool and then trace over the whole building with a thicker line weight. I need to join all of these lines together, so instead of selecting each one separately, what I'm gonna do is select one and then go into select, same, and then stroke weight, and that will select all of the lines that have the same stroke weight, so then I can join them together. I want to add a blue color to the whole diagram to kind of talk about the glass and the curtain wall. So what I'm gonna do is copy and paste the line weight, and then I'm going to change the fill into blue and then go into transparency and to change that into 50% or 25%. And the reason we had to do another line weight was because if you lower its transparency, it will make the line weight gray, and I don't want that. So that's why we have one line weight and then one line weight with the color overlay. And this is how the final diagram looks with all of the text. I mean, hello quality, nice to see you. I hope you guys found this video helpful. Let me know if you have any other quicker ways to handle the diagram that I did today, because as I said, I'm still learning and I would love to hear your experiences. I love you guys so much. I'm Rasha Shiruru and I will see you next time.